What's going on, YouTube? It's your boy 252 HUN. Yo, back again here with another video. In today's video, what I got for us is just it's a different reaction. We've never done this one, we've never seen this one before or anything like this. It's the top 10 most luxurious prisons. Yes, you heard it. The most luxurious prisons in the world. Prisons where pretty much everything is gravy, everything is cool. They're gonna look out for you, you're gonna look out for them. Whoop de whoop de whoop. Without further ado, shout out to the Riches. Link in the description to the original video will be below. Let's do it.
Never do it again. The world set up a form of punishment called prison. Prison is supposed to suck. Like, you get crappy food, you sit in your cell all day thinking about your mistakes, and you're probably gonna get beat up a few times for staring at Crazy Terry over there across the yard. Well, not all prisons are bad, so what's up everyone, and welcome back to Top 5 Central, where today we're looking at the 10 most luxurious prisons in the world. Leave a like on this video right now if you know someone who's gotten like arrested or went to jail, and comment the story. The person with the most interesting one gets painted at the top for everyone to see. But with that said, let's start with number 10. A prison where inmates live in brightly painted bungalows, shop at the supermarket, and cook their own meals might sound totally fictional, but it's how it works at Bastøy Prison in Norway. Prisoners are given their own rooms, allowed to go fishing or swim in the sea during free time, and go to school as well as work. It might sound unfair, but the country actually has the lowest reoffending rate of any European country, because inmates feel like they get to learn how they should live once they're released. Instead of scaring people out of committing crimes again, teaching them how to live better lives sounds a lot better, and it seems to be working too.
Yeah.
Number 9.
That's effective.
Justice Center Liepan is another prison that works a lot differently. I mean, the inscription on the wall says, "All persons deprived of their liberty shall be treated with humanity and with respect for their inherent dignity of all human person." And that pretty much tells you all you need to know. Prisoners live in cells with private bathrooms, kitchens, and even a balcony, and each room has a small outside relaxation space. All in all, 13 prisoners could live there at once, and as you can probably guess, demand is pretty high. That's my only problem with a prison like this. I mean, what's the point of trying to stay out of jail when realistically for a lot of people, life actually might be better in jail?
Mm-hmm.
Number 8. Addiewell Prison in Scotland is a dedicated learning prison, which means inmates are judged on how ready they are to re-enter society, not how much work they do or how quiet they keep. In fact, each inmate has to do 40 hours of productive skill building a week, which means that for them, learning is pretty much a full-time job. Their cells are actually pretty nice too. Every single one of them has a desk and a computer to help them with their learning.
That's fine.
Number 7. Okay, so I'm gonna absolutely butcher the name of this one, but the JVA Fuhlsbüttel prison in Germany is another place that looks more like a boarding school than a jail. I mean, the building is actually really beautiful, and each prisoner gets a full-size bed, private toilets and showers, a couch, a desk, and a table. They even get access to a conference room and recreation room. Help them swap their unhealthy interests for healthy ones and learn what interests them for when they get out. Number 6. So we all know that prisoners are supposed to change and get better while they serve their sentence, but this time the actual prison did too. I mean, Champdalen Prison in Switzerland had been famous for overcrowding and less than ideal conditions, but now it is totally different. Inmates live together in 3-person cells, which make prisoners feel less isolated and jail more like a college dorm room.
But
this encourages prisoners to share their progress with each other and work on building healthy relationships with others. I think that's really good for prisoners to be social and learn how to communicate with one another. After all, society is, well, a society for everyone. Number 5. I know we've already had one Norwegian prison on this list, but it isn't the only one in the country that's famous for being luxurious. I mean, Halden Prison is literally called the most humane prison in the world, and it's not hard to see why. Inmates live in apartments in groups of 8 and are only locked up for an hour a day. They're provided everything from napkins to heart-shaped waffles and can make their own food recipes from the library. Prisoners can play in bands that are broadcasted on the local radio and live in a building that looks more like a hotel than a jail, if you ignore the, like, you know, the giant concrete wall keeping people in. Number 4. Not all luxury prisons are European, but I've got to admit, China's idea of a high-class prison is a little less, well, high-class. Basically, their idea of luxury is that some prisoners are allowed to drink milk with breakfast and walk around unsupervised up to 6 times a week. They're even allowed to watch television in the afternoon and wear clothes given to them by their families. It might not sound like much, but compared to like Soviet-style prisons that are also still being used, it's considered super laid back. Number 3. Now, most of these luxury prisons have been a good thing for inmates, but this one, not so much. I mean, San Antonio Prison in Venezuela is only super liberal because it's run by a super intimidating prisoner who basically makes the rules.
Wow.
That means visitors come to the prison to, like, gamble or do drugs and walk by the pool wearing bikinis and holding guns. As for the prisoners, they join in the fun too, but it doesn't exactly stop them reoffending when they leave. Number 2. So this Santa Ana prison in Orange County is actually so good that it's become too effective. Seriously, the prison is now in danger of actually shutting down because there literally aren't enough inmates to keep it running. Those that are still there live in two-person cells with bunk beds, tables, and windows instead of bars. They also have huge communal areas where prisoners can watch TV, play board games, or just hang out and chat. However, since crime rates in the area have fallen so rapidly, the prison might have to be closed unless they start barring prisoners from other areas.
Oh,
how crazy is that? Our honorable mention spot is a little bit controversial, and I'd really love to hear what you guys think in the comments. Basically, Aranjuez Prison in Spain allows kids to live with their mom and dad in prison, but that means they also get locked up. To be fair, kids are only allowed to stay there until they're like 3 years old, and then they are sent to live with another family member outside of jail. Until then, though, parents can learn how to actually be parents, and the kid doesn't suffer because they weren't able to like bond with their mom or dad from an early age. Another really good thing to mention is that it also means that they don't grow up in a life surrounded by stuff their parents clearly aren't mature enough to handle, like drugs, alcohol, or violence. Number 1. This is another prison that is luxury, not because the government wanted to help prisoners, but because there's a huge amount of corruption behind bars.
Oh, wow.
Like the Pondok Bambu Prison in Indonesia allows rich inmates to sleep on double beds, receive spa treatments in their rooms, have karaoke parties, or even have maids wait on them 24 hours a day. That already sounds bad, right? Well, it gets worse when you know what the prison is like if you're not so wealthy. Non-rich inmates sleep on the floor of concrete cells without any bed at all. Sometimes with over 12 of them crammed into one room. So yeah, technically this is like a luxury prison, but you really don't want to be here unless you're super rich.
Right.
And there's a video on the top 10 most luxurious prisons in the world. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to leave a like and subscribe. It's free. Also, if you guys have any of your own top 5 or top 10s that you'd like to see, we read all the comments. So make sure to comment them down below. But anyways, thank you guys so much.
Alright, man, that will do it for this video. You guys, let me know in the comments. Give me 10 likes on this video. If you guys can give me the 10 likes and comment in the comments if you guys want to see top 10 worst prisons in the world. Y'all let me know, man. I'm back with the reactions. It's your boy Hundo Reacts. It's 252 Hundo, and I'm out. Peace.